This week on Rugged Expeditions, we're cruising down to southern Florida to chase the wily Osceola turkey. And when things aren't going so well, we enlist the help of a guy who just might know a thing or two about turkey calling.
Episode brought to you by the Pepe Family Jonas Brothers Studios, museum quality taxidermy since 1908.
Florida's an outdoorsman's paradise. You've got deer, gators, wild boar, fishing, and of course some of the best turkey hunting anywhere on the planet. Here we are in beautiful Florida, heading down to see some friends, do some turkey hunting. And we get to cruise along through these beautiful country roads. I mean, it really is a treat to get to see this part of the United States. Granted, it's the greatest country in the world, especially when it comes to hunting and fishing, but this part of the world, right here in southern Florida, really has a lot to offer. And I am pumped about getting to go here. While we're cruising, a lot of the time you can see one of these local radio stations might have some good tunes. You never know. Let's see what they got on here today. Hit the road again. Not an airport, somewhere new.
She said, I never had patience, and I'm losing them fast. And now the ticket man said, you got to get on last. Got to get back home. I keep moving away from you.
Finally, we're off the highway. Now we're on the dirt road leading into the farm. This is gonna be awesome. You can already see wildlife. As soon as we got off the pavement, you're starting to see all kinds of stuff here. Man, this is nice country.
Introductions were made all around, and we met our host, Mr. Pat Howell, and our trusty gobbler guide, D.E.
I was kind of surprised when I walked in and there's this big tall guy with an accent, some dude named Michael Waddell. Apparently knows something about turkey hunting.
Pat and his family run a fantastic farm. Their land practices prove that with the right balance, you can have cattle and wildlife coexisting in a balanced, healthy environment. Our guide, D.E., has lived in this neck of the woods his whole life, and he is the turkey-killing man in these parts.
We've got some turkeys way, maybe 300 yards away in an open field. And we thought they would come this way, but they didn't. They're just staying there, and now it looks like they're cutting off to the right, so. But we got a mob of pigs right here, but they're not coming close enough for a little shotgun action. There's still a chance that these turkeys might come this way, but they're too far away, they can't even hear us calling. But typically what this group of turkeys has done is they feed out there and then they work their way this way and then go up to roost over here. So we're hoping that they do what they normally do, but that's why it's called turkey hunting and not turkey killing. There's more of them have come back out here into this opening again now, but.
One long-bearded Osceola gobbler, running with a pack of jakes and hens, was working his way towards us. After ignoring us originally, apparently now my decoys have got a lot prettier. I guess it's kind of like closing time at the local bar, if you know what I mean.
Some birds. We've had birds come in, just not the right setup. But it's incredible the number that we're seeing, so I'm sure tomorrow's gonna be one of those days where it's, you know, awesome, and that we'll see all kinds of stuff. Have them strutting at 5 feet. The good news is, they like the call, they're coming in. Our day will come. It's time to call it a day.
Let's go, girls. We've got work to do tomorrow. You guys need to get some good sleep, all right? This morning, I set up a decoy near a tomato patch that was about ready for picking. Still a little green. DE said he'd seen a couple flocks nearby that needed a closer look.
Beat up bad. I think we're gonna let this one go.
God, he's got a nice beard, but he's just hammered. Half his tail is missing. That one there was easy kill, but when he's all beat up like that, it's just not the kind of bird you come down here for. You could never mount him like that, so. I mean, I'm sure he tasted great, but it'd be nice to get one that tastes good and looks good. Let's go find another spot. So let's just say that just when you think you know a little bit about turkey hunting, you run into the turkey calling-est human being on the face of the earth, Michael Waddell, and he proceeds to put on a clinic.
Let me think about this for a second. World champion turkey caller Michael Waddell wants to call for me. Sure. Sounds good.
Way to go. Was that a call or what?
I didn't know if I was going to get out of the way or not. I was like, I was backing up. I gave you the okay corral wink. Like, get it.
When they jumped over that fence there and I could see you between me and them, I thought, oh, great, here we go. We got the perfect setup and they're going to run right to him. They did, but luckily you were doing the belly crawl.
Oh, I was back because they was, I was thinking, man, if I can get out of the way.
Look at those spurs, huh?
That is a monster.
Man.
I bet that's a five-year-old turkey. What do you think, D?
Huh? Thank you. What a great deal,
though. D, though, Osceola King.
Man, my first Osceola.
Oh, congratulations. Man, that is awesome, buddy.
Look at that thing.
D is pretty.
That's pretty.
Boy, that's a nice turkey, isn't it?
That is big. I bet that's a 4 or 5-year-old turkey at least.
So he's still in good condition? Yeah.
Got a little bit of a
all
spot
that,
missing, don't know exactly what
that lipstick from. You put on his beak.
Here in South Florida, they got a bit of a pig problem. And rumor has it that they need managing. So here I am to give them a little Al Smith management plan 101. It's time to do some pig killing right here in Florida. Woo!
Pig hunting can really be a blast as long as the hogs read the script.
This spot here is the best one we've been to yet. There's tracks all over in the area where this feeder is. And out in these mud flats that are back over there, there was tracks all over the place. And they've been here today. You can see, even when we just came in, nobody's hunted out here all season. It's kind of out in the middle of nowhere. So fingers are crossed that this is the spot.
You know, pig hunting is a blast, and you're doing a good thing. As long as the pigs read the script that they're supposed to be on a TV show, like right now would be an excellent time for the pigs to show up. Here, little piggy, come out anytime now. Come on, where are you guys? Come on.
You know, we've given this pig hunting hell. We haven't seen anything. The good news is we still got a turkey tag left. So I say we beg the pig sticking and we go back to turkey hunting. Because I'm not sure where the pigs are, but and I know exactly where those turkeys are. I think it's time to go turkey hunting. Tomorrow morning, bright and early. Don't tell anybody, but Michael Waddell's still in bed. He's not awake yet, and I'm gonna borrow his funky chicken. I think it's the only one that's here, though. He won't miss it. Staircase or whatever that is there, that I might have a chance to get out enough in the open, and we'll try and get the decoy and try and get him to come to us. Keep those cows out of there. Look at that green machinery.
What a morning. I mean, get to come out here, shoot Osceola turkey like this. Great morning. We had some birds right off the bat come down. We didn't get a crack at those. Then we spotted these two over here. Turned out to be just the perfect setup. Had a little farm machinery to hide behind, which is an added bonus. But getting to figure out how to do these things, to learn from the man himself, where he showed us this whole decoy idea and being aggressive on the turkeys, where you're making an approach at them, we're wide open, and most of the time you're thinking, no, I gotta sit still, I gotta stay behind a tree, I gotta be completely camoed in. But you get out there, you be aggressive with that decoy, they think it's another male, and they come charging right to you. I've never in my turkey hunting career seen turkeys run full tilt across open pasture like this, right to you. Incredible. All right, Mr. Decoy, we better take you back to your rightful owner. Hopefully he hasn't missed you and knows that Al Smith has borrowed it for the morning.